Have you guys ever been in a factory? And if you have, any factory you've been in, was it beautiful? Welcome back to Minecraft Clouds of Darkness. This is Shade of Dead. This is episode 11-ish, I think. And today we're gonna, we're gonna do some nasty stuff today. So, now what I've done here is I set up some extra tables, and the things that we're gonna work with today. And you can see I built a little thing over here, pretty complex. But I built the things that we're gonna do today. I'm gonna do something a little bit different. I've got them all ready to go, and I'm gonna show you some of the stuff I've done. All right. So first things. Oh, this is my gear table. Because I'm tired of making gears and have to make an iron gear and then make a copper gear and then make an invar gear and then make a tin gear and then make a... No. So I just made a whole bunch of iron gears and stuck them in the middle here and then I can just make the ones I want. I don't have to make the iron gears over and over and over again. Why? Because everything in Mine Factory Reloaded, they're nice. They're not very imaginative. They are kind of blah. But I just thought I'd get this stuff going because I have the resources, and if you kind of do the same thing I did with the sifting, you'll have the resources too. But I've made a few things here. No, I don't want that one. Or do I want that one? No, I want this one. Sludge boiler. Now, I told you about that sludge that we were going to have from the harvester up there mining those trees. So I went ahead and I've got the sludge boiler, and you need plastic sheets, couple slab furnaces, machine frame, bucket, two factory blocks, and a redstone reception coil. You get yourself a sludge boiler. And I told you, if you make one of these, you want to stay... Whoa. Back down. All right. There we go. You want to stay away from this stuff, okay? Because it's not, sludge is not a happy thing, and it's pretty gross. So what I've done is I've set up a piping system. I didn't even need that wooden pipe because the harvester will automatically output its sludge into any fluid pipe you put it on. So I didn't need the wooden pipe. I don't know why I put it there, but I did. And I got it piped out here. Coming along here, and we've got our power cable. This is just a mess. It's not pretty, guys. I when I'm doing factory stuff, when I'm making a bunch of machines, I don't worry about pretty. I worry about, you know, have you ever been in a factory that was beautiful? Have you guys ever been in a factory? And if you have, any factory you've been in, was it beautiful? Was it a beautiful snowflake of a factory with... Was it Charlie and the Chocolate Factory? No. No. It was a complex maze of pipes, machines, and cement floors, and ugly. So, following that logic, I don't worry about it when I do all this stuff. And then you can see we've got a transfer pipe coming back out here going into this here chest right here. All right. So what I've done is I piped in my fluids. I've dropped them down here into these drums, and this is probably overkill. I definitely don't need to, but I didn't know how soon I was going to get into this and how much it was going to make. And basically, every block that thing mines, whether it's a leaf or a piece of wood, makes 10 sludge, 10 millibuckets of sludge. So that all gets piped over here and into this. And then what we're going to do is we're going to put our sludge boiler here. Why? Because this thing's dangerous. Okay? It is straight up 100%, 110% dangerous. I made way too many pipes, didn't I? Okay. So, I kind of go crazy anymore. When I'm building something, when I'm making something, I kind of go, you know, I don't want to build this again for a while, so I make like a stack or two stacks of it to do it. But, alright, so the sludge boiler here, Doesn't look like it's doing anything. It's got energy, 100 work, gets you one, so 100 ticks, which is what, 10 seconds, gets you one piece of work, and it's idle. It idles for one tick until it's got enough sludge, and I don't remember how much sludge it needs to do its job, but alright, this is open still. And I'm going to have it set up here, so if I ever need to get in here, all I got to do is like just break this electric cable and wait a little bit and wait for that to calm down and stop doing its nasty. It puts out particles, so maybe I'll be able to see them through the wall. I don't know how big. I forget how big the range is. But you don't want this near anywhere you're going to be for a long time. So before we get this thing turned on, we start pumping sludge into it, and I show you how terrible this stuff is and what it'll do to your teeth. It'll make your teeth fall out. I'm telling you, it's worse than you think. It's bad stuff here. We'll come on down here like that. We're going to put our transfer node on the side of our chest. There we go. So it should dump everything into this here chest. Or does it have a hole in the back? No, it doesn't. So we'll see if it... God, I hate working with this stuff. But, see, Mind Factory Reloaded has got a bunch of crazy stuff that you can get these extra fluids, as it were. One of them's you can make like a meat packaging plant. But we can watch the sludge come down through here. Here it comes. Here comes the sludge. You can make like a meat packing plant that makes liquid meat, which you can then turn into meat ingots. We may do that too, just to show you. I might not bother with that. I'll need to do something for the animals. But the meat packing thing, just, or the, this one, making the meat ingots is not that cool. It doesn't work in a lot of the recipes. Doesn't work with Pam's Harvest Craft for sure. So we might have to figure out a different way of doing that. And it just flows down in here, and it's going to fill up these here barrels. I'm going to have that pump in there. But sludge is one of them. Another one is a sewer. You can put a sewer block in the floor underneath where your animals are. And at first it's just the one square, and you can upgrade it and it'll do a bigger area. And basically if there's animals there, it creates sewage. Gross. And then you can pump the sewage out into a sewage thing, and you can do stuff with it. You can make fertilizer, and you might be able to make power with the biofuel. I don't know. I can't remember if you can do that or not. I've started building out that way. I didn't go all the way out there yet. I'm going to go all the way out there. But we'll go out there and check it out maybe today. I don't know. It depends on how much time we got. But anyway, I'm rambling again. This is why everything takes so long. Is because I just don't shut up. But I guess that's kind of my job. All right, so we got everything ready. And I'm going to show you the nasty effects of this boy. Let's see. Yeah, you're going to work. And you're going to... All right. So let's get this thing pumping. I'm going to show you what this thing does to you. All right. I'm going to get ready to run because it's not good. All right, it's filling up. There. It's done it. I got hunger. I got poison. It's not a nice thing. It really isn't. You get hunger for a really long time, and that's no fun. It just eats up your food real fast. But it's going to sit there, and it's going to pump that sludge in there into that machine. And then that machine, I hope, is going to start making things. It made some sand. It'll make dirt. It'll make some clay. Sometimes it makes mycelium. It can make all sorts of goodies. So if we go to, I don't know if this will show us what we can get here. I don't think so. And I don't even think if we type in like mycelium, if it will show. Nope, it's not going to show what sludge boiler makes. But it makes all sorts of stuff. And that thing's going to sit over there, and it's going to, well, it's made some clay and it's made some sand. It'll make dirt. I think it makes the dirt too. Also, that like grass won't grow on sometimes. It makes, like I said, mycelium sometimes. It just makes stuff. It just makes some blocks and turns the sludge into other stuff. But like I said, it makes, it's not a pleasant environment to be in. I don't know if I can see the, so you can kind of see it. See the smoking? Oh, you see, I was putting up some particle effects every now and then. Hold on. It'll do it again. There, see him? So if you get close to this thing while it's boiling sludge, well, the air must be pretty toxic coming off all that boiling sludge. It's just pumping away, ain't it? And it's just going to make us stuff. And we may as well. We might get some stuff that we can't get otherwise. Made some red sand. You know, hey, we got some dirt now. We'll come back here later and we'll check on it and see if it's made anything, you know, cool or different. I'm wondering if it might make some of these other things like fertilized dirt and stuff. I wonder if they program that in. Oh my God, it's a blood moon. I did not notice. Oh, dearie. Well, we're just going to be careful. And if I need to, I'll cut to a thing. Now, this is Sparta. It was ground to bits. See more butts. And to make this easier to clean out, instead of me pulling up there and vein mining the top and then coming back down and waiting and then going back up and blah, blah, blah. I went up there and I put in 4 redstone lamps kind of in the corners a bit of this thing. And then I ran red net cable, not red net energy cable, red net cable, all the way down the side of it here and connected them on top. Oh crap, here they come. Oh boy, where you can spawn on those pipes. Oh my God. All right, well now I know. This is a nightmare. No. All right, but I connected red net cable. Oh my God, here they come. All right, it's a red net cable. Look at me trying to stay calm. Rednet cable just transfers a redstone signal. Okay, so that's another way you could power those redstone engines over there, pumping your lava or whatever. You could put those across the top, but it runs a redstone signal. So I just put a switch at the bottom. If I flip that switch, it'll light that up, turn on those redstone lamps, clear up air, and yeah, it's a long ways, but it'll carry the signal the whole way because it's to be used with this other machine that you can vary the signals and sort it and tell it to do this and then that, and then that thing's super, super complicated. And I've never gone that far into doing some sort of automation that I needed to have that fine of a control and specialty. And it's a really cool thing that somebody took a long time to build, I'd say. But boy, oh boy, I don't think I want anything to do with it. And that thing, I was going to show you also how much experience that thing has sucked up and what it's done. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut here. And once this blood moon is over, which, is it pretty? It's pretty. Isn't that pretty? All right. Once this blood moon is over, I'm going to come back and we'll do a couple other things. So just hang in there. I guess I will too. We'll wait for this blood moon to get over. I'll be right back. All right,
y'all. Looks like sun's come up. Monsters haven't quite all disappeared yet. They will. Let's give it a second. And we'll go out here and we'll do some more stuff. I really did not know they could spawn on those red net energy cables. So tip for all of us, I guess. Be careful when you're running your cables all over the place that you keep them well lit. But that looks like a job for glowstone. Probably going to put some glowstone blocks up there. Or maybe I'll build a saw and make some of those glowstone nooks like our island was originally lit up with. These guys just keep dying. This makes... Oh, look at that. I got to go through here and throw a bunch of this stuff away, the bows and stuff, all this stuff. It's just about, I got some Enderman heads. Maybe I need to make a container for that. I don't know. Some leather. I probably should do that too. This one's full as well. Oh, jeez. And, oh god, that one's full too. So are we backed up here? Yep. Yep. Yep, we is. I think I'm going to need to put a trash can at the end of all this to just start voiding out some things. And I learned something about this. All right, I learned how all of this works. And how to make this route exactly like you want and not connect to itself. And it's confusing and it's not very intuitive. And, all right, so when you right click on these, okay, it puts these dashes on it, right? Okay, so the dashes mean, let me get it right here again. Okay, so when you have a dash, it means that the items will flow in through that, but it will not go back that way, okay? And so if you have two and you set them up, so, you know, it'll go this way because this is clear, or this is clear, this is clear. This will go back up here. Well, can I? There we go. That'll definitely always go up here, go this way, go this way. And I've got it set up to just kind of walk itself around, go all the way up, and that way it hits all my barrels. And I haven't wired these ones in yet, and I may do that here in a little bit. But it'll do this, and that way I can get all my stuff and choose, you know, okay, I want to store up this. And I tell you what, I've been trying to get essence seeds to start magical crops going a bit. Here they are, essence seeds. How do you get them? You sieve fertilized dirt. I have sieved two stacks of fertilized dirt. It's supposed to have a 3% drop chance. Not a single essence seed to be found anywhere. I've gotten all the other magical crop ones. I've gotten like all this stuff. I got all this stuff. I got that. I get this. Cannot get this drop. 3% chance, and it just won't do it. It just won't. It's terrible. Terrible. Anyway, our sludge. Let's check on our sludge. It's been running all night. Let's see what this has got in here. Oh, we did get some mycelium. There's some mycelium. We got some heat sand. I don't even know for sure. We got some soul sand. I got my netherrack, baby. Some clay, some gravel, some red sand, and some podzol. All right, and so here, I think this dirt, the 3:1 dirt, I think this stuff will not grow grass. It just stays dirt all the time. All right, but anywho, last thing I want to do today is talk about the induction smelter. And I talked about it before, and this is how you can make your diamonds. You know, you need two copper gears, redstone reception, which is gold, and one bar gold, and two pieces of redstone, some Invar ingots, another machine frame. You're going to make a lot of these. I suggest when you get ready to start doing all this, you just make a bunch of these, and you make a bunch of those, what's the other one? Factory machine blocks. Just make a bunch of these, and you'll be ahead of the game. When it comes to crafting, it won't be quite such a pain if you just make a bunch of them at once. But the induction smelter, and it's just a bucket, and we'll get one of these. I got my bucket back. That's cool. I didn't think I'd get my bucket back. All right, so I don't know how this works. Let's just set it here real quick. Okay, yep. So we're going to want to put it in that direction. We're going to want, well, yeah, we'll put it like this. Boom. All right. And then it's powering up. Okay. And you can set this thing up to take inputs and put them in different places. You get an extra one, you get a green, which you can use to put and purple, which you can use for, because it's got two inputs here. And we're already charged up. But what we're going to do is out the back, we're going to send both these, and that don't matter right now. I might automate this at some point. Pardon me. And I'm just going to have a spit out here in this chest, which has got junk in it. It's got all my flint and some cactus seeds and some jungle tree seeds and flint shards. And I realized it before, and I just couldn't be bothered to fix it. But this auto packager will make your coal, will take your coal powder. No, not spawn. What? All right. Where is it at? There it is. It'll take your coal powder and it'll turn it into coal. Okay? Which takes 4 coal powder to make 1 coal. And you need coal powder or pulverized coal in order to run this thing and make diamonds. Okay, so let me see if we got some diamond dust in here. We got some diamond dust. All right. And so I turned this pulverizer back on, put the power connected back up, and I ran it, and we got some pulverized coal. And I guess it makes sulfur too. Whatever that's for. I don't know. How much wood we got? Oh my god, I'm gonna have to. We do all this automation, then I just end up with tons of stuff. This is gonna start spitting. We'll leave it. And also, maybe I'll be able to show you guys it spitting this. see if it will. I don't know. It might not. I don't know. We'll see. See what happens. Start spitting stuff on the ground. Okay, so you come to your induction smelter, put your diamond dust here. And I pulverize coal, and it, like I said, if you pulverize coal, you only get one, like a coal piece of coal, you only get one pulverized coal. Man, where did I pick that up at? Oh well, you only get one piece of coal, of pulverized coal back. So if you can save your coal powder, it'll make this easier. You're not going to get a ton of diamond dust though. That's all right. Let's throw that in there, and boop. Making diamonds. And there we go. We got ourselves a supply of diamonds. And we can just make more whenever we want. And however we want. And wherever we want. And it'll be fine. Well, what did I do? I don't know. Okay. But it's just going to keep running. I guess it uses 2 coal. Yeah, it looks like it uses 2 coal per diamond. So it'll do what it can do, and then I'll worry about it later. And so we've got some extra stuff here, and this is cool because now we've got my ceiling. This heat sand, I don't know anything about this heat sand. Let's get it out and play with it. Let's see if we can set ourselves some. Oh yeah, we want the mycelium. We'll put the mycelium back for right now, but we want the heat sand. Let's see, does this burn you? Does it burn me? I don't seem to be burning. We put a crucible on it. I got some crucibles somewhere. I got some extra crucibles somewhere. Let's see if it'll power a crucible. Oh, yeah, I cooked them. That's right. Boo-boo. Will this make heat? No, it does nothing. It does nothing. I don't know, but maybe if you sift it, you get something different. Oh boy. We may have to set up a whole nother sifting. Do I have to have a shovel to mine that? My mattock has gone missing, and I don't know where it is. Oh well, we're gonna punch it and see if it breaks. If we get it, yeah, we got it. So I don't know. Can you sift that and get something different? Heat, sand. Let's see what we can do with it. We can make slime soil. We can make soul sand out of tainted soil and heat sand. Oh, tainted soil.
All right.
Now, somebody commented that maybe I can dig up the tainted soil in the village. And I thought you meant... I didn't know that there was actual tainted soil. But the tainted soil in the village is something different. Heat glass, I wonder what that's for. Okay. We're looking. Oh, you can't sift it. Okay, so I can just make stuff out of it. But I gotta get some of this tainted soil. Tainted soil. Whoa. I can't make it. Comes from the nether, I was told. But if you get some of that and some of this heat sand, you can make your own soul sand. But this thing seems to be making soul sand. We got 3 soul sands. We got 2 nether racks. Oh, wow. We're just getting a bunch of good stuff here. Some pods all. It's probably out of sludge at this point. I'm gonna hope. Oh crap. Monsters can spawn up there. Man, that makes me mad. Is it still? Yeah, alright, so my sludge tanks are empty. So we'd have to, I don't know. Okay. Hold on, guys. I wanna see if this'll start spewing things out. Here, let's just fill it up a little bit with a couple things. Put that sulfur in there. And put that lever in there. Alright, so now it's pretty full. Let's see if we can make it spew stuff. And we'll make some sludge while we're at it. Trust me, that planter has got more saplings than what it knows how to do. And I figured out why it keeps spitting saplings on the ground. And the reason is, if it in this mod pack, if you break a leaf and... Alright, so if you have like 2 leaves connected to a tree trunk and you break the inside leaf, the one on the outside automatically despawns and it might pop off a sapling. So that's where our saplings are coming from. Ooh, look at that. Some werewolves out tonight. And... that's not quiet, is it? And... so if you do that, it'll, is it spitting out on the ground yet? It's gotta be clear. Here comes the wood. All right. Just gonna make sure. Good lord. There it goes. Watch, it's just gonna start spitting. See, it's just spitting it out on the ground because there ain't enough room. There ain't enough room, I tell you. There ain't enough room. Well, that's all right. We got a solution. We do. I don't think there's anything in this. Nope. I had this left over from... I made a whole bunch of diamond. Just trying to store all that stuff. And, well, it ain't working out like we want it to. There. We'll put all this wood in there. I hate to lose it all. Oh crap, what have I done? Why is this connected? No. There we go. And if you put it white like this, it's a pipe-to-pipe connection only. It will not connect to anything else. I can put another chest here on top and won't connect to anything. So that's something to keep in mind. There goes our wood. And it's just gonna fill her up again. Pumping. And this thing's gotta be just about packed full. I took some out and threw them over the edge because it was getting full. And I didn't want to have the stuff flying out everywhere. So that's the problem with these transport pipes. Is that they don't care. They're just going to go, well, I'm supposed to send it this way. I'm going to send it this way, and I don't care if there's room for it when I get there or not. It's just going to keep sending it. So, something to keep in mind. But I think they're cool. I like to watch the stuff go through here. And I think we're going to get into, because it's kind of become necessary. As much as I like these work great, I think, for the fluids. Just simply because it won't start squirting fluid out all over the ground. But I think we need to get into a better, similar transport system called tubes. Tube. Filter tubes, extraction tubes. These guys here from the tubes mod. Tubes. They're not too hard to make. It's just almost the same thing. It's just plastic, though, around glass. And these are, you know, cobblestone or stone or diamond or whatever it is around glass. Now, these will work for some stuff that we have going here. But like I said, I think they work best as fluid pipes. And I get to have my cool redstone engines pumping away and thumping away over here. Just ka-chunk, ka-chunk, ka-chunk. Looks very factory-like. Very much so. Can you just... Where are my torches? Can I? Oh, well, heck, I can. I can just do that. And we can light this up if I can... Derp! There we go. I can light that up that way. That'll be fine. I'm going to fall off the edge. I got to get some more fencing up. I am terrible about almost falling off the edge. This fence that I have had up here has saved me so many times, because when I'm kind of just running around getting stuff ready for an episode, I tend to, you know, watch either some other YouTuber or Twitch stream or Netflix or, you know, whatever. Or I'm having a conversation with somebody and I'm like, okay, well, I got to go over to the house, and then I'll just turn my head and I just kind of get myself pointed in the right direction, and I just turn my head and start walking. See, that's why they keep popping out. It's because it's destroying the leaves on the inside first. I'm like, okay, I got to go over here, and I'll just kind of turn my head and look away, and I'll be like, yeah, okay, yeah, or I'll be watching whatever, and then pretty soon I'm running up against something. And oftentimes, I've found myself standing here several times with a panicked look on my face when I turn back. I'm sure you can imagine. And out this way too, I got lucky. Before, when I first just had part of the bridge here and I didn't have the fence on it, I was heading over here and I ended up right here, or like right here, and I got stopped right here and I didn't go any further. And I could have easily just walked right off the edge of this. And I haven't really done anything over there. You can see it on the mini-map if you look. I've just got the area ready. But I've been going in here and I've been planning out how I'm going to build it and what I'm going to build and where. I think we're going to need to get ourselves a farm going. A farm as in an animal farm soon. I don't need it. But why shouldn't we have it, you know? We might use the Mine Factory Reloaded stuff, but I don't know. Mine Factory Reloaded gets used a lot, and I've used it a lot. And it's just not... I don't know. There's less imagination with it. And it's just this complete answer to your problem. You want to breed animals? Build yourself a breeder. You're done. It's going to breed your animals. It'll just keep breeding animals. What? You're getting too many animals in your pen? Okay, we'll build that other thing that pulls the animals out. So you tell it to pull the young ones out, and you just keep breeding them inside your pen. And every time you get a young one, it gets pulled over here. And then you slaughter that guy and turn him into liquid meat. You know, there's just... I don't know. Mine Factory Reloaded gets used a lot. So, while I've used it here to make some of this stuff and do something, I mean, the pulverizers and this stuff is thermal expansion, but this is Mine Factory Reloaded and that harvester's Mine Factory Reloaded, and we got that sludge. But I may stop there. I might build the sewer just to kind of show you guys what that's all about, and what you can do with that. Like I said, I don't even remember what all you can make with sewage. Sewage. Can you craft anything with it? No. And it's not going to tell you. But the sewer, or the sewage thing, I think can't use as biodiesel. Sewer collects it. I don't know. I got to go look and see what the other machine is that takes the sewage and then turns it into fertilizer, industrial fertilizer, or something like that you can use. You can use like bone meal if you want, but it's really not that useful. We don't really need it, and it's gross. So we're probably not going to do that. But I'm going to, I saw I had like 7 stacks of zombie flesh over here. So hopefully at some point I'll come up with the ability to get an essence seed farm started. I'll make some more fertilized dirt and I'll just keep on sifting and see what I come up with. Because right now all I'm getting is strawberry seeds and crap. And alright, so how much do we have here? Alright, so this guy's full. It's pumping as fast as it can. That's full, that's full. Oh my god, are they all full? Okay, no. These two are almost full. I have 6 drums to collect essence in. 6! Alright, so I got 256 buckets and these 4. This guy's pumping as hard as he can. I first made these tanks. I went and mined up some obsidian. I got a diamond pickaxe around here somewhere that I use for that. Mined up some obsidian and put it all together, and maybe it disappeared when I lost my mattock. I don't know what happened. I lost my mattock. I'm very upset about it, but put this together, made these tanks because they're cool looking. You can, like, if you connect them together, it fills up across the bottom like it was one full, like an aquarium or something, like it was one full tank all the way across. It doesn't like fill one block and then fill the next block. They look really cool, but they only hold 16 buckets a piece. And I'm like, I'll just make some drums. I got lots of iron. I'll make me some cauldrons, make me some pressure plates and stuff. And lo and behold, full, filling. I'm going to be maxed out again here real soon. So I guess maybe I need to, is the shower in this one? Is experience shower in this one? XP shower from open blocks. I don't know if that'll work with that, but it'll work with this. So maybe I'll go ahead and make more of these tanks, run it, clear up the wall or something crazy, and I can set myself up an experience, an XP shower, and start burning that XP. I don't know, can you just bucket it and drink it? Can you do that? See, it goes down all the way across. You can't see it. It didn't do enough there. Can I just drink that? No. Can I put it down? Yes. What did it do? It gives me night vision. Well, heck! For a minute. Get night vision for a minute. All right. Well, that's kind of cool, actually. I kind of like that. Yeah, I figured. Okay. I put my fancy lanterns out here. Pop some more of these things. All right, we better get some lights down here just to make sure. Okay, I need to put some lights on that. But I need to start getting the experience points. And the reason why I want to work on getting lots of experience points levels is this mod pack has some pretty dangerous things in it. When you start to go on the adventures, it gets pretty dangerous. Heck, just the mobs, just the plain old mobs are pretty dangerous. Why is there light in there? Did I flip the switch? I don't know if it's on or off now. Oh, it's night vision. Derp! I'm dumb. All right, so there are lots of mobs in here that are really powerful. There's all those special infernal mobs that can just kick your butt. We got to go to Atum, which I don't know. That, depending on when we go, will determine whether or not that's dangerous or not. We got to go to the Twilight Forest, and there's a bunch of monsters there. And one of the last things is Wildecraft. And Wildecraft, well, it's based on RuneScape, and if you've ever played that game, it's really hard, or it can be. And, well, we're just going to end up dying. there are some bosses from Wildecraft, from the Wildecraft mod that are... You can have the best armor that we could make in this pack. We could have red matter, enchanted, awesome boss armor of never taking damage, or essence-infused armor. I don't know which one's better. Whatever. And we can go up against some of these bosses, and they'll just... boom, kill you. They'll just boop, and you're dead. Boop. Boop. And so... we need a way to survive, because I know I'm not playing on hardcore, but I want to play it as if I was, you know, kind of for those of you who want that particular challenge. I think it just kind of takes some of the fun away. For me, it does. But for those of you who want that particular challenge, what you can do is get yourself one of these grinders or something similar. Collect all the mob essence up, all the experience, and then give it to yourself. And whatever armor you're going to wear, make yourself a last chance. Last chance. Or last stand. Is that it? Last stand? No. Last. I know that's an enchantment. Maybe there's not a... maybe it doesn't have all the books in here. If I put in protection. Yeah, it doesn't show me any of the books. But if you can make a last stand enchantment book, okay, you can then survive. Because what that does is when your hit points drop below, it would kill you. If you take enough damage to kill you, then it takes some of your experience levels, some of these boys right here, to keep you alive. And so if you give yourself 200 levels, because I'm telling you, this hasn't been running that long. It really hasn't. Like, a few hours max. Maybe 5 hours max this has been running. And we are nearing being full. And this must be completely plugged up now. And it just can't handle it. Why isn't those going in the Ender Pearl thing? Oh, I don't have... oh, I do too have an Ender Pearl thing. It's that stupid transfer node is jammed up, is what it is. It's that transfer node. It's got this in it, doesn't know what to do with it, so... see more butts! Alright, and so... I guess what we're gonna have to do... I'm just gonna hook up, at this point, I think I'm just gonna hook up one of these on the end of that daisy chain and be like, okay, that's where everything else goes in the trash, because we're gonna get so much stuff, it's kind of gross. I mean, we're jammed up now, so it's not gonna kill anything more, won't make any more experience. So you'll probably end up having to do that, just the sheer number of drops and stuff you get. And I guess all the stuff you do want to save, just run it through and put it in barrels like that, and then it'll save that stuff in the barrels. I mean, if you get 64 stacks of 64, you know, spider eyes, do you really need any more? Probably not. You might want the inner pearls. You can upgrade these barrels and make them hold more if you really want to. So what happened here? So does that break when it gets wet? Is that what? I don't know. We got ourselves some mob essence. Can you make the straw? Let's just see real quick. Straw. Yep, you can make the straw. We can go make straw right now. And I'll show you what we can do with this stuff. Ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch. And this is kind of a cheap way to do it, to make your to get your experience back. It, well, cheap. It's not cheap. It's kind of a pain in the butt. But you can drink liquids with this. So I can drink that up. I put this in here and I got, see my experience? Pay attention to my experience now. Wink. But that's a way you can get your experience. Boop. Maybe I should set up some mob essence spots around the island, and then when it gets nighttime I can just keep dunking myself in these and get night vision so we can all see what's going on and it's not quite so bad. I don't know. I think we should go check out these islands. I actually never have. And I know I'm getting netherrack now, and maybe I don't need to. You know, I've got some netherrack. I can get more. But I still think we should check these out. I mean, they're all here. They're all close by. I mean, relatively. There's that thing. See, sometimes it just don't show up. Sometimes I gotta, like, I don't know. There's that island out there. I want to go to that one, too. And we'll go to this one. And we'll check it out and just see if there's anything on it. Who knows? Maybe it's got treasure in it. And go to the slime island. And whoa, I'm gonna fall off. I better just stop. Maybe check out these little ones. There's plants growing on it. Maybe flowers of some sort. Maybe we need those. I don't know. But yeah, I think that's something we should do. So, oh, I get it. On a blood moon, they'll spawn on any place. They can spawn anywhere there's ground, they can spawn. Maybe they can't spawn on fences. I don't know. But anywhere there's ground, they can spawn. So even if it's a slab, they can spawn on it. So they consider this ground, so it'll spawn on it. Or it's considered a slab, and it'll spawn on it. Oh my gosh. Oh, I filled it. Well, I didn't mean to do that. But, alright. Well, I'm going to end it here. And, alright. Well, one last thing. They are planning to do, or they are in the works of, making Clouds of Darkness 2. Well, whether that's just a patch update, but it sounds like it's a whole redoozing of, like, this whole thing. It's going to be Clouds of Darkness version 2. Part 2, whatever. And so when that happens, I'm probably going to do a reset on this, because I'll probably do like one more episode and just kind of talk a bit about what the rest of this holds. But this one, unless they've changed things, maybe I'll go into a test world and get I don't know. Maybe I'll get that OP edition quest book and see if they've changed some of the end quests and made them better, because when you get to the end, it kind of, like a lot of these, it's so much work to make one of these, and I understand they get towards the end and they're just wore out and they're like, I just want to get this thing released. And so the beginning part's really cool and fun, and then as you get like right up to the end, it's just like, well, what's left to do? I don't know. I don't want to think about it. My head hurts. And then it just turns into kill 20 of these and stuff like that. You know, 64 stacks of 64 quadruple or octuple compressed cobblestone or something. So yeah, we're probably gonna, we may not even do all of this map when we do it, or here, even if they don't get the second one released anytime soon. We may not even do the rest of this, all of these quests in this map, because some of them eventually turn that way. We'll at least check everything out, but I don't know if I'll go through and do some of those quests like that, because they're not fun. And basically, by the time you get to that part, you've won the game at that point. Oh, there's a skeleton with a dispenser on his head. They're like, we want to murder you. I'm like, no. But I'm going to have to get this all sorted out here and get myself a trash bin up there just to collect some of that up so we can start killing these. But see, they're already starting to explode out the sides now. I don't know what that guy's wearing. Oh, he's wearing glowstone. They can make glowstone armor, evidently. Evidently, you can get glowstone armor. But thanks, guys, for watching. I appreciate it. I hope you liked it. If you liked it, tell me so. If you didn't like it, tell me so. And I will talk to you guys all later. Oh, and keep a lookout. I'm going to start another mod pack just to have some variety. And I'll try to do... I'm going to try to do an episode of each every day. So we'll get 2 episodes a day coming out. And it's going to be a lot different than this one. In a lot of ways. But appreciate you guys watching. You're the best. No, you're the best. No, you. All right, stop being cute. All right, have a good day. I'll see you guys all later.